remember. I had a glimpse into the past. You're going to have to do for me what I once did for you.
How was it going back into your wheelchair?
It was a treat going back into the wheelchair, but especially because, well, for two reasons. This time I was sitting in the chair wearing a superhero costume, not just in a suit and tie and shirt like before, but I have my own leather, black leather
outfit.
That's
a good costume.
It's a very cool costume. And also because one of the chairs that we used to have, I think we had three chairs in all, actually hovered. It had compressed air and you could lift it up off. It lifted itself up off the ground. That was quite cool.
How do you see these X-Men films evolve?
Well, we know what we're doing now, sort of. When we were doing the first one, it was very hard to, you know, establish the characters and establish the world for an audience that hadn't read the comics. And have each character have an arc and have a story, have an arc, and figure out how to do it visual effects-wise. I mean, I remember it was sort of like taking it day at a time. Now we know who we are, who our characters are. We know sort of how to do the visual effects, and so now it's just focusing on a very good script.
There's certain things that Brian has to worry about as a director, and then there's certain things that we worry about as actors in terms of, like, are we getting the right beats or the relationship sort of at the right moment? You know, what the sort of wants of either characters are within the scene and the sort of objectives throughout the entire story. So the scale of it and how it's presented, I think, you know, if everybody was going and putting their oar in with the director there, it would be a mess. So it's, you know, I think that's his job.
You'll need me as well. Side by side to end this war. Before it ever begins.
So, I wake up in my younger body and then what?
Find me. Convince me of all of this. It's going to take the two of us.
And where do I find you?
A different path. A darker path.
How was it working with a cast like this for you?
Fantastic. I mean, it speaks volumes about how good these stories are because you attract Ian McKellen, Patrick Stewart, Hugh, Fassbender, all these, you know, they're great actors. We have three Oscar winners in this movie. That says a lot.
Were you familiar with the actual comic book, Days of Future Past?
Oh, I had heard of it and had not read it, actually, when I heard the idea. I was sent, actually, the idea, which was originally Matthew Vaughn. He sent me a one-page synopsis of it, and I immediately knew I was in. I mean, first of all, it would have been hard to say no to with that reunion and that cast coming back together. But it was turned out to be extremely easy to say yes to, you know, because it was honestly an incredible storyline that I knew would surprise people.
We've seen a lot of screenwriters, producers become directors. Would you direct something like the next, X-Men Apocalypse or...?
I won't direct X-Men Apocalypse. Yeah, I am interested in eventually directing. I love what I do. I love writing and producing. It gives me a chance to work on a few things at the same time, which you can't really do as your director. And I love working with directors. I mean, really, my favorite parts of the process are working with directors and actors.
Logan, I was a very different man. Lead me. Be patient with me.
Patience isn't my strongest suit.
I don't want your suffering. I don't want your future!
Please. We need you to hope again.